Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 2 of Pokemon Fire Red. Well, you see, I had an excuse to see something kind of screwed up to start the game during part 2. During Mel's first time at Fortis last night. But I couldn't do it. So, yeah. And of course, Nick's nickname is Alice without minus an E from Pandora Hearts. I might as well stop making slave now. What's this bad about? I would have taken on the first or second gym, to be honest. Could catch Pokemon are temporary to use, but I don't want to consider that yet. Remain? From the Horror High School Host Club series. Wait a second. Since apparently it's hard to train your Pokemon in Fire and Leaf Green, it's really hard to grind. It's hard for it to grind up. So, the best you can do is just fight every wild Pokemon you encounter. Now I'm going to show you the inside of the Pokemon Center. And I have no clue if he was my first... I have an idea of my first official team member. Apparently, I was confused on Let's Plays for a bit. So... I might as well, like... I thought I could try and get my audience involved. But since I... barely have any views from the first part of this Let's Play. It is very sad. And this is it. Anyways, this is what I wanted to show you last episode. A potion. Now... I'm going to have more. See this old man throw a Pokeball at a Weedle. I actually have no problems with any player character in any Pokemon game. But I do wish there could be more uniqueness to the hair color, eye color, skin. But I hope that's why Bob's death. TTTV. One of my favorite uses in this game. They teach you how to do a buffet phase. If you're a rookie, then watch it. Now, I'm going to look for my second team member. Now my second team member, a Pidgey. It took a while. Took about a couple minutes. So now, to think of a nickname. We're gonna call you... This nick name is actually from Gutama, even though it's mainly the last name. But sweet. Tetsuma Sakamoto. He likes ships and stuff. Airships and such. But apparently it gets air sick. First thing to do is an episode 23 in case you care. Or curious. Now yeah. Shall we get inside? Now we just introduce the Pokemon Center. It may be different from Ruby, but similar emeralds and one thing which I will eventually show. Or I've already did. The Union Room is actually what introduced that to like everyone knows in Generation 4. In Generation 5 and probably Generation 6. Of course I barely used the Union Room in Generation 5 because of iron. Technically, the direct corners mainly is the training thing for like the first three generations. This is what I was referring to. Since this game did introduce the Wilds adapter, now off to the Pokemart. In this episode, I am probably going to start entering the Viridian Forest. Three Pokeballs should be good. And five antidotes. You definitely need antidotes. I am not kidding. Up to the Viridian Forest. Knows that Melee has Weedos. And everyone knows what Weedos do. They poison you almost every time. I will be doing some training before I challenge Rock. It'll probably be in episode 3 or 4. Which will be the earliest beating my record of one of the most recent videos, my black episode 5 of my black tooth. This is a Caterpie. I'll be explaining what we'll be doing. Oh, the 19 HP curse. For some reason, at least one or two Pokemon at the start of the game, I always get 19 HP. Going to level 5. I don't know why. It almost always happens. For instance, Green Bean and my Pokemon Emerald Rock Fruit. 19 HP at level 5. I might as well tell you the wild Pokemon here. Caterpie, Kakuna, Metapod, Weedo, and very rarely Pikachu. So, once I get this item, potion, we go set to fight. The Tierney class is not in the Generation 5 for any reason, in case anyone notices. Bug catchers. So the only thing is fighting the forest. If I sped this up, it would have been easier, but I can't speed up. Sadly, since no cash GBA. Sakamoto Google level 6. Cool. I have Netflix and really have a spot. I despise the winter months. Because almost always I get sick. But once I had a strep throat in January. Late December, I had a flu. The cure for my strep throat got me a rash because I'm allergic, because apparently it made me discover that I have an allergy to penicillin. Funny thing is, I actually didn't like the taste of it! This will be the last battle I'll be doing in this episode. Just in case of anyone who... I will finish this the next episode. By the way... I want to ask you guys something. Even in regards to a different walkthrough, but I'll ask in that particular walkthrough anyway. Would you want me to do Q&A videos? For, say, gym battles? Like, since I'm doing a Pokemon Black in my 2 walkthrough where I can speed up, really. But please, it'll be easier to do so. And as earlier... Oh no! Like I said earlier, Weedles get poisoned, can be dangerous. Especially since you can't survive with 1 HP in this game. That accounts for this introduced in Generation 4 with Diamond and Pearl. But luckily in Generation 5, they eliminated completely. Welcome to... Well, it would take longer if Sakamoto fought against Kuna on its own. So I'm not going to bother and switch back. Because mainly, all the Kakunas do is harder and takes forever. Even though some of them may have poison sting. Yeah, a bunch of grinding up. All in the same episode. Trainer tips. Normally we have no purpose for them, but... I can care less. So, today's question of the video is, have you ever used a bug-type Pokemon in Fiveret or Leafgreen? Or even Generation 1? Well, that's it. So, I'll see you on Monday. Because I upload on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. To make it so much easier, rather than doing 4 videos a video week, like what I try to do for 3 or 4, like when I try to do Black Tooth. I'm gonna go faster. So, see you next time, Pokemon trainers!